this is the coding for enabling two interrupts. Okay, so there is a timer 0 ISR is being written. There is a timer 0 interrupt. For timer 0 interrupt, there is a separate interrupt service routine is being written here. And in the interrupt service routine, what it does, it will set the lower order 16 bits of port 0, port 1. Okay, so timer 0 interrupt service routine will set the lower order 16 bits of port 1. And timer 1 interrupt service routine, you have written a timer 1 interrupt service routine, which will set the higher order 16 bits of port 1. So timer 0 ISR sets the lower order 16 bits of time input output port 1, and timer 1 interrupt service routine sets the higher order 16 bits of input output port pin. Okay, these two are the interrupts. Okay, and we have written a main routine. So these two are the interrupt service routine, and we have written a main routine. This main routine, we are enabling the interrupt, right? Timer 0 interrupt initialization. So timer 0 and timer 1, timer 0 and timer 1 interrupt is initialized by making the two bits as 1-1 in an interrupt enable register. So vectored interrupt controller interrupt enable register is loaded with 0x30, which enables both timer 0 and timer 1. So which interrupts need to be enabled? To enable those interrupts, we have to set the corresponding enable bits. So 2, that is 3, that means 0011 in the 4th bit and 5th bit. So exactly speaking, because it is the hexadecimal representation, the 4th and 5th bit are made as 1, where the 4th interrupt is timer 0 and 5th interrupt is timer 1. Hence, by making it as 30, it enables the timer 0 and timer 1. So now we are enabling the timer 0 and timer 1. After enabling, we have to give the priority to the time enabled interrupts, right? So we are given the priority to timer 0, highest priority to timer 0, and we have given the lowest priority to timer 1. Highest priority to timer 0 means the control register 0 will have the highest priority, control register 1 will have the next lowest priority kind of things. So lower the number, higher the priority. So what interrupt that we are assigning it to the control register 0, so that interrupt will have the highest priority. Similarly, the next lowest priority is what interrupt that we are assigning to control register 1. Okay, so the control register 0 will have the fourth interrupt, which is timer 0 interrupt. Control register 1 will have the fifth interrupt, which is timer 1 interrupt. This two denotes the enabling the priorities kind of things. In the vector and the control register 0, in the data sheet, we can identify this very clearly, which has been discussed. So after enabling the timer 0 and timer 1 interrupt, and after choosing the priorities for timer 0 and timer 1, where timer 0 is having highest priority and timer 1 is having the next highest priority, and we have to notify the vector locations, right? Through the vector address register. Okay. So vector address register 0 will have the vector, that is ISR location of timer 0. Vector register, vector address register 1 will have the interrupt service routine location of timer 1. That's all. And because it is timer interrupt, so timer need to be started. So both the timers need to be started properly. So the prescaler registers and the match registers and the match control registers are, the control registers has been initialized and the timer was started, which is timer 0. And similarly, timer 1 is also started with timer 1 prescaler registers and match registers and the match control registers, and timer 1 was started. So timer 0 was started as well as timer 1 was started. Both timer 0 and timer 1 was started, and whenever the time comes, that means whenever it matches, when it will match, when the timer counter register will be equal to MR0 value 2, that is MR0 value 2 means then it will create an interrupt, right? So that is why we have given it as 3, where the reset on match and create an interrupt on match, create an interrupt on match from this. And the main routine, we are toggling port 0. In the main routine, we are toggling port 0. In the interrupt service routine, we are using port 1. So what is happening? Something is happening in port 1 means that denotes it is a ESR, where the lower order 16 bits of port 1 is modified like this means timer 0 ESR is running. Higher order 16 bits of port 1 is changed like this means then we can understand timer 1 ISR is running. So there is a main routine where the initialization of interrupts and the timers and GPIOs is being done, and the while loop will keep on blinking port 0. Whenever the timer overflows, that means whenever the timer matches, it creates an interrupt. If timer 0 matches with the set value, it creates an interrupt. If timer 1 matches with the match register value, it creates an interrupt. Timer 0 matches means it runs it, the program execution jumps from main routine to the timer 0 ESR. If timer 1 interrupt occurs means program execution will jump from this main routine to timer 1 ESR, and after completing the ESR, it will come back to the main routine and will complete the routine. So okay, let us do the single step execution. Let us compile build and rebuild all. Let us compile build and rebuild all. Let us compile build and rebuild all. Now we are enabling the interrupt, right? Now we are enabling the interrupt. Now none of the interrupts are enabled. None of the interrupts are enabled. Now we are interested in timer 0 and timer 1 enabling the interrupts by making BIC interrupt enable bit as 30. That means by executing 23rd line, both the interrupts timer 0 and timer 1 will get enabled. Let us look at it. So now we have executed 23rd line. So timer 0 and timer 1 interrupt got enabled. And we are choosing the priority for timer 0 and timer 1 by executing the 26th and 27th line as we see here. So we have executed 26th line where this interrupt request 0. Now we have assigned the 0th priority for timer 0. Now after executing the 27th line, we have assigned the first priority for timer 1, IRQ 1. So this type denotes timer 0 is having highest priority than timer 1 as shown here, which is done through control register 0 and control register 1. After that, the vector locations of timer 0 and timer 1 is being notified by the correspond by executing the 30th line and 31st line. That means vector address. So by executing the 30th line, the corresponding address was assigned to timer 0, which is vector location, and by executing the 31st line, the corresponding vector location of corresponding timer 1 is 240, which is also assigned to the corresponding vector locations. So now the timers are initialized, its priority has been chosen, and its vector addresses has been given, and the interrupts are enabled. So first we are enabling the interrupt, then we are assigning the priority, then we are locating the address of the corresponding interrupt service routines. Okay, here we are using two timer interrupts, hence its priorities and its vector address, and those interrupts are enabled, which is very clearly visible in the vectored interrupt controller window, which is quite interesting, right? And timer 0 is initialized and timer 1 is initialized, the same thing as we all know very well. So whenever timer 0 matches with the timer counter value matches with the match register 0, it creates an interrupt. Then when the interrupt is generated means it goes to the ESR. Now you can see the direction registers are enabled, and the program execution there is there in the main routine, right? Now the program execution is there in the main routine. Now you see the program execution is there in the main routine, where you can see. Now I'm running this code. Simply if I'm executing this in a single step, right? Now I'm executing in a single step. You can see port 0 is keep on blinking, you see. Port 0 is keep on blinking, right? Port 0 is keep on blinking. Why? Because main routine. So timer, both the timers were started, right? Both the timers were started. Here you can see this is timer 0. And we are interested in timer 1 also. So go to the peripherals and select timer 1. So now both the timers are here. Both the timers were started because TCR is 1. and because the prescaler values are loaded with 1 lakh, its hexadecimal equivalent is F4240. Because the prescaler value are loaded with 1 lakh, and its hexadecimal equivalent is F4240, timer 0 prescaler value, and timer 1 prescaler value is also the same. Okay, so timer 1 prescaler value, so timer 0 prescaler value is this, and timer 1 prescaler, so timer 1. So timer 1 prescaler value is also same F4240, because both timer 0 and timer 1 are initialized with the same 1 lakh prescaler value. And it is getting counted, right? Timer 0 has counted up to 64, timer 1 has counted up to 60. And when you do the single step, it will keep on incrementing, right? When you do the single step, timers are keep on incrementing, and 40's main routine is keep on executing, right? Main routine is keep on executing. So when the timer interrupt will get generated, so this is the timer interrupt register, right? The right hand side, if you see, this is the interrupt register. When timer 0 interrupt comes, this bit will become 1. When timer 1 interrupt comes, this bit will become 1. When this bit will become 1, when you look at this code, whenever the MR0 becomes 2, okay, so match, whenever the TC becomes 2, whenever the TC value becomes 2, then it will create an interrupt. So when TC value become 1, once if the prescaler counter reaches F4240, then only it will become 1. Again, the prescaler counter will start from 0 up to F4240, as we know very well. Like this, it counts. So when I keep on doing this, only port 0 will keep on blinking, right? You can see, when I keep on doing the single step, only port 0 will keep on blinking. So this will happen up to 1 lakh counts. This will happen up to 1 lakh counts. So it is very difficult for us to do this, and it is not necessary also. So what we can do is, we can go to the ISR, we can go to the interrupt service routine of timer 0, and we can keep on breakpoint. We can go to the interrupt service routine of timer 1, and then we can keep on breakpoint, and let us run this code. So we will check the interrupt register will set, and the program execution will go to the ISR, and we can observe that the timer overflows, that means timer matches, something like that. Okay, so I am running this code now. So it has run, and which interrupt was generated? Timer 0 interrupt was generated. You can see TC has become 2. When it becomes 2, it has to create an interrupt. The code was written like that. When it becomes 2, it has to create interrupt, right? When match register 0 has to become 2, it has to create interrupt. Now it has become 2, so interrupt was generated. Okay, because interrupt was generated. And the program execution has jumped to the vector location, which is timer 0 ISR. Timer 0 interrupt was generated. Program execution, you can see the yellow color arrow mark is pointing the fifth line. Program execution has come from main routine to the ISR. So here you can see in the register window, the program starts from user mode 2. Program has jumped from user mode to the interrupt mode, where the return address, that is the stack pointer, and the link registers and the SPSR registers are loaded with the necessary values. Okay. So now in the ISR, interrupt service routine, what we are supposed to do? The interrupt service routine should make the lower order 16 bit of port 1 as F. So this is GPIO 1. Lower order 16 bit will become 1, and the higher order 16 bit will become 0 after executing this. Let me do the single step. So this IR equal to 1 means clearing that. Now it has cleared the interrupt, right? You can see it has cleared the timer 0 interrupts, and it will make the port pin as 0F, port 1 pin as 0F. I am doing the single step, it has become 0F, port pin 1 has become 0F, right? 0000FFFF, which justifies ISR1 is executed. Then this is the syntax where we have to give this vector address as 00. So it will come back to the main routine, right? Now after this, it will come back to the main routine. That means it is jumping to the main routine. Then already the timer 1 interrupt was already generated. So the program execution jumps to the timer 1 ISR. Okay, program execution has come to the timer 1 ISR, sorry, timer 1 ISR, and then it clears the timer one interrupt register. You can see it clears the timer one interrupt register. And this timer one interrupt register is set as interrupt is generated. So going inside this and clearing that and making the higher order 16 bits of port 1 as FFFF, making the higher order 16 bits of port 1 as FFFF. Higher order 16 bits of port 1 as FFFF, and then coming out from this window. Here the interrupt is highlighted, it will go to the user system after coming out from this interrupt service routine. Now the program execution has jumped from the interrupt service routine to the main routine. Here the user or system mode is available. Now it is keep on blinking port 0 only. It's keep on blinking port 0 until the timer overflows. Now the timer was not yet overflowed. So it will keep on doing this. Keep on blinking this and until the timer will overflow. So when I run this code, again it comes to the timer 0 ISR. Again if I run, then timer 1 ISR, then timer 0 ISR, timer 1 ISR, then I am running. So you can see timer, now I am running this code. Just like that I am running this code. What happens? It comes and stops at timer 1 ISR. So 0F will become F0. When I run this, 0F will become F0. And it goes to the timer 0 ISR. Program execution stops here. And when I run this, come to F0, keep on. So now I remove this breakpoints. You can see all the ISRs as well as main routines will run. So now I'm running this. Now the program will never stop. You can see everything will get executed, right? So port 0 is keep on blinking. 0FF is happening for timer 0 and 10 is happening for timer 1, and then it is coming for this. It goes on. So all the interrupts are executing, all the main routine are executing. You can see both the timers are running, both the timers will set, and then it is clearing. This is how interrupt works with respect to LPC2148 microcontroller. More than one interrupt means we can choose the priority like this, and then we can make the code to run like this. So we have to choose the corresponding application, right? Now without any specific application, just like that, I'm just showing the interrupts, how it works. And based on the application, we can use the timer 0 interrupt for audio and timer 1 interrupt for video, where audio quality has to be given more importance when compared to the video quality. So for video we can use timer 1 interrupt, and for audio, that means for microphone sampling, once in 125 microseconds, we can choose the timer 0 in such a way that it can interrupt once in 125 microseconds, so microphone can be sampled for timer 0 interrupt. Timer 1 to display screen, display refreshing. The screen can be refreshed once in 20 milliseconds. So 20 millisecond delay can be given in the timer 1. So every 20 millisecond, timer 1 interrupt will get generated and it goes and refreshes the screen. So timer 0 for 125 microsecond time delay, which is periodic. Timer 1 for 20 millisecond time delay, which is also periodic. So timer interrupts are the interrupts which produces periodic time delays as per the application requirement. One of the application is display refreshing, where once in 20 milliseconds, the screen has to be refreshed. So periodically, once in 20 milliseconds, you have to use one timer to refresh to execute the interrupt service routine or the display routine. Display routine must be the ISR. Similarly, the voice interrupt, voice input, that is microphone, need to be sampled once in 125 microseconds. For that, another timer has to be configured. Like this, it goes on. So this is how timer works with respect to ARM processor, ARM controller, which is being demonstrated. So in the mode, as you see in the mode, you can see it shifts between the user mode as well as interrupt mode. So when I give a breakpoint here, it switches from the user mode to the interrupt mode. When I keep a breakpoint here, sorry, when I keep a breakpoint in the ISR, right? When I keep a breakpoint in an interrupt service routine, program will come and stop in the interrupt service routine, right? Program will come and stop in the interrupt service routine. Hence, you can say the program execution has gone to interrupt mode, that means interrupt request mode, IRQ. So again, if you run this, it has come to the another interrupt. Here also interrupt request mode, interrupt mode. Again, if I run this, I can keep the breakpoint here also in main routine, where I can able to identify program execution is a main routine also. So I am running here. Let's come to the main routine. So mode is user mode. Mode is in the user mode. You can see user. When I run this, for some time it will come to the interrupt mode. When the flag sets, it will come to the interrupt mode. Okay. Because again here I have kept this now breakpoint. I'm running this, it comes to the interrupt mode. Because program execution comes here. Now I keep a breakpoint here. It is in timer 0 now. When I run, it will go to the timer 1 now. But again, it is ARQ. Again, if I run, it will go to the user mode. So user mode and interrupt mode, how it runs, how it switches, everything is being simulated very clearly. So this is the hardware interrupts, external interrupt inputs, where I talked about level and edge triggering. Level and edge triggering, there is an external interrupt pin where external interrupt 0, 1, 2, 3. So interrupt register is there, where there is 10123 is there. And there is a interrupt wake-up register, external interrupt mode register, and polarity register controls. Interrupt flag register will notify whether it is level or wedge triggering. And there are four external interrupt flag register, like external interrupt 0 is generated means this flag will set, and 1 is generated means this flag will set. The interrupt is happening in the pin P0.1 or 0.16 with respect to external interrupt 0, 0.3 or 0.14 with respect to external interrupt 1, 0.7 or 0.15 with respect to the external interrupt 2, and 0.9 and 0.0, 2.20 and 0.30. Its alternate function is external interrupt 3. And there is a wake up registers. And there is a brownout detect wake up and RTC wake up and external interrupt mode register. The mode will decide whether it is a level sensitive or edge sensitive. And again, the polarity decides whether it is level 1 or level 0 in terms of level triggered interrupt, or falling edge or rising edge in terms of edge triggered interrupt. Okay. So low active or falling edge, or high active or rising edge. So when there is a hardware interrupt, we have to look at all these things. And interrupt structure with respect to hardware is available like this. Now we have seen the software interrupts. This is how the hardware interrupt works with respect to LPC2148 microcontroller. So mode will decide, the polarity will decide, and the corresponding pin. So corresponding pin along with all this external interrupt pin, right? The glitch filter, right? Glitch filter, you talk about glitch filter means it is normally a skimmy trigger. Okay, this is the pin. From the pin input is coming. So the polarity and the mode, based on that, there is a pick lock which decides and gives the input to the vector interrupt controller. And based on the program, as like how we did the program, based on that it works. Okay, this is the hardware interrupt structure with respect to LPC2148 microcontroller. Timer 0 and timer 1 are software interrupt structure. That's what we have to come. So with this, I will conclude.